Our family's been ranching in the Laparelle Valley of Wyoming for 135 years. This land, the prairies, the foothills to the Laramie Mountains, the gorges carved by the rivers and the forests, the long outings with our dad, moving cattle in 90 degree heat, driving down the road and bumping our heads on the pickup truck, putting out salt blocks, spending countless hours on the tractor putting up hay, and celebrating our community at Brandings every weekend in the spring really came to define who we were as people. Nevertheless, when I turned 18, I was excited to get out and explore the world and get away, see the ocean and surf the waves in California. And it wasn't until I left that I realized how much that this land and this community meant to me, and how important it was to help it continue to thrive and help the ecosystem that it's based on continue to thrive. Our vision for a hub is twofold. First, to take a deep dive into the principles of holistic resource management and create a plan to ensure that we are taking positive steps to improve our ranch's land, water, air, wildlife resources, cattle well-being, and the values that we care about on a daily basis, while enabling both my sister and myself to come back and live in the place that we love. Second, and more importantly, is to utilize what we've learned about holistic resource management to help our neighbors find solutions to the issue that face our community. We hope to impact our neighbors to the north by helping them find a way to keep six families on their ranch. We hope to help our neighbors that are looking for creative ways to market their conservation values through the sale of vegetables and beef. We hope to help the local businesses that have started up in Douglas, such as the new brewery, the coffee shop, and the saddlery that's been there for 25 years, to figure out how to thrive despite the influxes and outflows that are associated with the mining and oil and gas economy. And maybe we're dreamers, but we hope to impact the coal mining families, oil and gas industries, professionals, and the decision makers in those industries to bring more emphasis on ecosystem health and community values into a profit-driven resource extraction model. Both the ecosystem and our communities face significant challenges in Wyoming. We're at the south end of the Powder River Basin, where ranchers and environmentalists fight about prairie dogs, surface owners and mineral owners struggle with mineral extraction and the subsequent siting issues associated with oil and gas development. Air quality has become an issue in Wyoming of all places due to our dependence on oil and gas for our revenues. And the economy generally faces a lack of diversification. If you want to stay in Wyoming, you better have a ranch, a trust fund, or want to drive a truck at the coal mine or roll up your sleeves and get to work on an oil and gas rig. Wyoming has both thrived and dove in boom-bust economies since I've been alive. And the principles I've learned through Alan Savory's books, the Savory Institute lectures and teachings I've watched online, and the holistic resource management principles are a way we feel like we can help to break that cycle. Why here? We're better. We've been talking across the fence lines for years, but we're still depending on a boom-bust economy for our children's livelihoods. What's unique about Wyoming is that despite the differing perspectives of ranchers and the oil and gas industry and outdoor recreationists and hunters and anglers, is that unlike in some other states and some other locations where each sort of individual is separated into different pockets in the state, in Wyoming, all of these people live together all across the state. I've worked in the conservation industry for over 10 years. I've worked in the business world. I worked at a corporate law firm for 3 years. I wrestled competitively for 30 years of my life in tournaments all over America and the world. I've been a climbing guide and climbed 20,000 foot peaks in South America and the Himalayas. In each and every one of those experiences, utilizing the principles of holistic management could enhance the work, planning, the coordination, and the activities that I've participated in. My sister's traveled to probably 50 different countries. She's taught English as a second language in remote villages across the world. She's edited and marketed books for a small independent publishing company in California, and she now works in the marketing department of a large corporation producing educational materials. My dad taught us the values of conservation at an early age, In fact, I remember him correcting someone who asked him about raising cows for a living and saying he doesn't raise cows, he raises grass, and the cows are just the vehicle that he uses to manufacture the grass. And we've been fortunate enough to travel around the world together as a family, in each case making it a priority to visit local agriculture communities. We've consulted with a new operator on a collective far east of Moscow, Russia, who was raising cows he shipped up from Dagestan. And to the south, we visited the Sputnik Stevenson cattle operation, which imported purebred Black Angus and Herefords from Montana. We've manned plows for local tobacco farmers in Cuba, visited the communities in Chile where my dad was in the Peace Corps, introduced them to worming medicine for their pigs, talked with Lebanese farmers about their water struggles in the Ka Valley, and visited ranches in South Africa. And in one of our greatest experiences, had the opportunity to learn from hub applicants and Mr. Sabry himself on his ranch in Zimbabwe. Thank you.